But without any further ado, here is Pete's take on the year that was in 2022.
Ah, 2022. You sure had it all. Just as well, because the years that came before weren't too much chop.
Pete, can you just please keep the vibe up?
Yeah, sure. Of course I will. Melbourne, you really made the most of it, didn't you? We got off to a flying start when our Ash at a home tournament became our first Australian Open singles winner in 44 years. The Queensland champ's third Grand Slam title was one to savour. 2 months later, the 25-year-old shocked the sporting world when she announced her retirement from tennis.
I know that the time is right now for me to step away and chase other dreams.
On ya, Ash. If that headline came as a shock, it was nothing compared to the awful news that came to us from Thailand.
Australia has lost one of its greatest cricketers of all time.
The great Shane Warne left us tragically too soon. The King of Spin was sent off on an emotional night held at the venue which he made his playground and where a stand now bears his famous name. Farewell, Warney. You made your mark. And like others who left us in 2022, you will be sadly missed. And of course, 2022 is the last year of service from the longest standing monarch we are likely to see for a very long time. More than a million Londoners lining the streets to say goodbye to Queen Elizabeth II. I thought this was supposed to be upbeat. Anyway, we hailed a new king, but not before honouring two new Melbourne monarchs of our own. My dear friend and colleague Peter Hitchener and Fifi Box declared Moomba royalty as our favourite festival returned to the banks of the Yarra. And not to be outdone, a special mention to another of our own, Clint Stanaway, who competed admirably in the Birdman Rally. Oh, better luck next time, Clint. Oh, and Clint, can I get my favourite tracksuit back? Mother Nature made her mark on 2022. Floods ravaged much of the state. In October, the SES received a record-breaking number of calls for help. Among courageous stories of survival, there were harrowing accounts of devastation. The great Cane Corns battled the elements and some cranky truck drivers on his 725-kilometre run from Adelaide to Melbourne. Retracing the steps of Shane Crawford, he achieved his mission in 12 days to raise funds for My Room Children's Cancer Charity.
The final tally raised by Cane Corns, $337,000.
On your volcano. After a two-year break, the Firelight Festival and its red-hot attractions burst back to life. Over 100 performers wowed and warmed us over three otherwise chilly nights in July. The State Library and Collins Dome became catwalks in Melbourne Fashion Week. 600 designers turned heads, just as Robbie Williams did on the last Saturday in September. The Cats were unstoppable against a hapless Sydney Swans as the AFL Grand Final returned to its rightful place. We celebrated Christmas in the city with the giant tree and projections proving why it really is the most wonderful time of the year. We also had our fair share of big name guests in town, including Guns N' Roses and the Piano Man. With his one-night-only performance, Billy Joel left 76,000 of us begging for more. You asked for it, I'm here to deliver. Try this for upbeat. Coley Chase rocked the G. Fans in stands we love to see. The Cats did it easily. Not bad for the elderly. Bowie's built it ever long. Why'd they do it in Geelong? Royal Rumble, Netflix bomb. Mavericks back, bravo Tom. RBA turned screws. Bill's up more than Avatar 2. Bud's goal, Daisy's bling. England's got a new king. Rafa's record at the French. North got Clarko off the bench. Golfers go and live it up. Messi the GOAT wins the cup. Anzac crowds at the Shrine. One more deal, Gill calls time. Elon's Twitter, lettuce shortage hits the zinger. Data hacks, Wordle scores. Homes passed in, Scott Cam's four. Maths cheats, Tracy's tears. It really was one hell of a year. Phantom Theatre matinee, National Gallery, go today. Ballet stars hold their feet. Time stands still at Flinders Street. Warning, Simo, ONJ. What else do I have to say? Only joking. Melbourne in 2023, you are peaking. Pete Smith speaking.